Welcome back to FTL Faster Than Light. I'm your Captain Laylight, and I'm finally back. A couple weeks ago I got back from a trip to Albany, and, I also was sick with a cold. Well, it wasn't even a cold, it was a respiratory virus. I'm mostly over it now, so I'm feeling back up and ready to do some more video recording, but I decided to start with FTL because it's a quick project I can just do in one day and get 4 days worth of material out, and it just feels like a good way to kind of get ramped back up into production. Anyway, I was trying to, just before this session started, figure out what ship I wanted to play. It's still kind of hard for me to pick, but I think I'm gonna go with Mantis C. The other two ships are a little bit more complicated, and this one tends to have a decently smooth time once you make it out of Sector 2. So I kind of just want to give myself something a little bit easier to play, just to make sure that I'm in good shape. We'll see from there. I'll try and get to everything all in good time, but anyway. So this ship is... Let's just get started. These names are all fine, not gonna mess with anything. Let's just go. So, this ship is considered one of the better ships in the whole game because of the four-man teleporter right here. And unlike Mantis B, which also starts with a four-man teleporter, it seems a little bit weaker. You don't have two shields to start out with, you only have one, like most other ships in the game. You don't have a defense drone, you don't really have any kind of damaging weapons. So all you have are this Mantis over here, you have this Lanius, and you have an engine. But you actually start with a clone bay, and that's going to make a huge difference. Because unlike Mantis B's tactics that require you to keep the crew alive, on this ship, as long as your clone bay is safe from damage, you can let your crew die as much as you want, and you can recycle the teleporter a lot faster than that. And you also start with an NG to actually get stuff fixed on this ship in a reasonable amount of time, compared to Mantis B, whose main Achilles heel is not being able to repair things well at all. And on top of that, the venting layout on this ship is great. You have airlocks over here, you got one down here, you got three over here, you got a whole bunch over here, over here. I think this is one of the best layouts in the game, period, for venting. The only thing that's a little bit annoying is that the shields and the weapons are here at the front of the ship. They can both get hit by beams, they're a little bit vulnerable if you have a defense drone. Engine's a little bit out of the way, but other than that, this is a really, really solid layout. It just works great for what it is. Handling borders on board your own ship is hardly ever a problem, and it's probably one of my favorites to play. I'm not sure if it's the favorite. That probably goes to Zoltan C. But anyway, I've rambled on long enough. Let's just get the run started so I can actually show how this plays out. Okay, pretty standard opponent here. They have managed to shut down my engines, but that's fine because I wasn't going to be manning them anyway, and I probably wasn't going to be dodging this missile anyhow. So, when you're starting out, it's always a little bit iffy. Do you want to start your Mantis directly in the teleporter, or do you want to start them on sensors so you can see what crew are on the enemy ship? I usually don't really care that much about manning the sensors in Sector 1 because it's usually fairly obvious who you're facing. The only time it really matters what a sensor view looks like is maybe in Sectors 2 or 3 when you might see a pirate ship like this one that has three or more crew in it, and then you might care if there's like three Mantis on there or if it's just three Zoltans. In this case, the other decision you need to make before you get started with this ship is how many people are you going to be teleporting over on the first wave. I think for this, actually, because we're not going to be dodging anyway, yeah, I'm going to get the NG over here, just to make this go a little bit faster. Just in case it's two Mantis. Okay, it's not two Mantis, but it could have been. So anyway, we were not going to be dodging this missile anyway, but I want to be able to beat up these crew a little bit faster. Okay, that's still fine. So you can see that the NG is helping prepare for this. I could use a stun bomb here to do one ion damage. This is easily overlooked here. I'd like to move my pointer, but I can't, so I'll do this instead. So this does one ion damage. That means that I can turn off one of these weapons right now if I want to. However, I believe there's a fair chance that I'm only going to turn off the ion stunner and not the missile, so I'm going to save my bomb. Now that said, you start with 20 bombs, so again, especially when you only have one shield, feel free to just go ahead and use these to make your life easier. The thing about these is that they don't actually do... neither of these do crew damage. So you can't use them to actually kill people faster directly. You can only do it to kind of hinder their movement or keep your crew safer. So neither of these are going to help me avoid taking damage from this missile. All I can really do... I'm going to chase you in here. Get you killed, and then maybe I can... Alright, how's this going to work? See, right now he's running away from the... this room. Like, I forgot to mention this, but you start with Alanius, and one of his crew abilities is to kind of suck the oxygen out of a room as though it's a whole breach. So this room right here is out of air. So the Rockman is nearly dead, Mort there. He is running away from this oxygenless rooms, which can actually be kind of annoying sometimes. So I think... I don't think I can convince him to go up into piloting right now, so I'm just going to chase after him with my crew and run my NG up there. Alright. Yeah, that one already fired. Yeah, so not much I could do about that. And he's dead. Okay. So the nice thing about playing on this ship is, well, first of all, this is kind of a special case scenario. The only reason I bothered bringing the NG over in the first place was because my engines were hacked, and I would have only had, like, 5% evasion anyway. So I figured rather than have a 5% chance of dodging either of these two shots, I'd rather have a third boarder to kill these guys faster in that 2x2 room you saw there. And I think that did help. I don't think it actually, like, made a difference this time as far as, like, did it fire two missiles or three. I think these guys would have been good enough, but I think maybe if there were two Mantis in there, it might have made a difference. Okay, so that's my story. Let's get ourselves fixed up and move right along. I'd like to have my NG repair the engines, but also not die. I don't know if I'm going to use them again, though, in the next fight. Let's just see what the map looks like. If we're going to, like, a distress or something, I probably won't bother cloning him. But if we are going to, like, a fight, yeah, nothing obvious. I'm going to go ahead and clone him first. Alright. So, yeah, you can get cloned, and then I'll have him finish repairing the engine so that he can have one repair experience. Again, this is the kind of skill level up micromanagement you don't really need to do, necessarily. But it's nice to think about these kinds of things occasionally, I suppose. Alright, let's get these fixed up real quick. You don't have any kind of... In fact, actually, you have two combat skill. So I can go ahead and kill you off and you'll have one, and that'll be okay. So I say this all the time, but I'm going to say it again just before we get going here. For the most part, I really don't care about what level my boarders are. I only care about how many and what type of them I have. And to some extent, what composition the enemy crew are, of course. The difference between level 0 and level 1 is decent. It means that you tend to win ties. But the difference between level 1 and level 2 does not really make a huge difference as far as my tactics are concerned there. So, pretty much any time I... can, I'll clone my boarders up to full health, just to make sure that they're at full health. That makes more of a difference to me than whatever tiny amount of skill they lose. In no time at all, they tend to get leveled up to gold anyway, just through normal playing the game. So we have nothing to upgrade, so let's move on. On a ship like this, I'm not too interested in finding distresses. The NG can help a little bit. Okay, this is a little bit awkward, actually. So we're going to want to, yeah, waste a lot of time before we get here, and then just take these four jumps, I guess. Okay, another standard ship. Well, we're definitely not surrendering a crew member. That's, I think we can take that as a given. Here's another two-crew ship. In this case, I don't think sending the NG over is going to help that much, because there's no... 2x2 room here for where you can help kill the enemies faster in. You could think about doing that anyway. Like, I could board two people into the shields room and put the NG on this, the weapons. But the problem is that I don't really have any guaranteed way of taking that down. Although, actually, now that I'm thinking about it, here's a new tactic I'm just thinking about just now. If I board all three of them on, I could have two people punching the two crew of this ship in the shields room. The NG would go into weapons, and it would take him about 14 or 15 seconds to punch down a weapons bar. And that would probably not turn off the missile. But, right, so he will do that eventually, though, even if it's on Artemis. So one of those will go off, but what I'm thinking is he'll punch this down. That'll turn off one weapon, probably the laser. And then if I stun bomb it after that, because I've punched down one of the weapons successfully, then the stun bomb will turn off the missile. The problem is that only matters if like there's like two Rockmen in there and it takes so long to kill them that this gets to fire twice. But that's like enough of a thing. Like, I'm gonna try that out just right now. This is educational. We gotta try all our options. So, alright, that's not really where I wanted you, so you can go in here. Okay, it's two Zolt. It's a Zoltan and a Rockman. Okay, in this case, yeah, I just want to kill the Zoltan as fast as possible, then. So again, I'm deliberately choosing not to dodge this missile. Most of the time in Sector 1, you're not going to dodge these anyway, but in this case, like, it's a little bit more risky because I'm giving up a 15% chance to dodge the missile, which is, again, not very much. But what I'm banking on is, like, there is a chance in here. Like, I don't know if it was even, like, 15% chance, though, that there are two Rockmen in here, but I think it's a fair chance that that's possible. And if that were the case, it might have gotten to fire this a second time. Okay, that's also a thing that can happen. Okay, so I killed the Zoltan, and now, because I killed him faster with the help of the Mantis does more damage, just hand-to-hand combat than the Lanius does. The Lanius only outputs as much damage as a human. I got to... this one is dead, and now I'm at 2-1 status faster. So now the stun bomb is ready. Okay, so that did turn off. I'm gonna go ahead and... no, they did not turn that off. Don't want to launch a stun bomb to save one damage. I think I might have actually waited too long to do that. Like... I might be able to. It's purely the hull damage here I'm concerned about. Like, there's... if it shoots the teleporter, if it shoots the clone bay, I don't care. None of that matters. It's just, do I want to spend one missile to save one hull? Probably not. There will be better ways to spend missiles later, I think. So I'm just gonna take it. Yeah, and see, it fired so quickly there, I would not have been able to turn it off anyway. Yeah, that was the other thing I was thinking about. Because it takes a certain amount of time for the stun bomb to launch here and then appear on their ship and then explode, and I think in that time this laser would have gone off anyway. So, nothing to be done about that. Oh, very nice. So we got the best result from this slaver ship here. We can pick a crewman. So there's just we already have an NG, so it's a toss-up between Mantis and Rockman here. Mantis will kill people faster. Rockman will give us free blue options in Sector 1 and 2. I think all things being equal, probably the Rockman just for the blue options will be about as effective. Having the Mantis for the extra offensive power to maybe outpace the whole the missiles is nice, but the Rockman can give us, I don't know, free augments or free scrap. And generally, free scrap is a little bit better than maybe saving, like, 3 or 4 hull damage, at least in Sector 1 and 2, because repairs are pretty cheap, and you just want more ways of getting more scrap than maybe dodging a little bit of hull damage. Because scrap obviously means you can upgrade your systems and then take less hull damage that way from things where timing isn't quite so important. So, Rockman. Yes. And the nice thing about that is we both got the Rockman and we got some free money out of that, too. Okay. So that was a really bog-standard fight that could have been interesting, but actually just kind of wasn't. But, oh well. So, you are definitely going to the teleporter. There's not really much I can do about you. You're just, unhealthy, and that's not much I can do about that. Probably default course of action is just going to be station people like this, and then run the Lanius in, do the teleporter, and just have three boarders. Again, I can have four if necessary, but I think the difference here between these three guys and adding a fourth guy who happens to be an NG, I don't think that's so great anymore. Anyway, so that takes care of that. We'll go ahead and get the shields 1.5 for safety. I nearly always recommend that on all ships. There's only a few cases in which I wouldn't recommend that, and they're few and far between. Not going to a store, or am I? Do I have anything to sell? I could sell the Mantis Pheromones and maybe the Crystal Lockdown Bomb, but I don't think there's any reason to yet. I just spent my money. So, no, we'll keep these for now. I guess now's as good a time as I need to go over the tools, because I kind of just glossed over them a little bit earlier. So you start with a Stun Bomb. It takes 17 seconds to charge up, which is a very long time, actually. That is pretty slow. In return for that, you get one ion damage, which is not great, but it's better than nothing as far as turning a weapons off is concerned. And you get to stun enemy crewmen, or every crewman who lands in the... every crewman in the room that it lands in, for 15 seconds. Yeah, the description over there says stuns all crew inside the room. So that is a tremendous amount of time. It means that if you can micromanage the enemy crew successfully, then you can essentially completely immobilize them and pound on them for free with your boarders. The tricky part is just darting in and out of the room, which a Rockman is kind of bad at because of his slow movement speed, but the Mantis are especially good at. So that's probably the breadwinner on this ship. The Lockdown Bomb I don't really care for as much. I'll go back to this screen. 15 seconds, which is very slightly faster, but not that much faster. And the only thing it does is create a dense wall preventing the movement in or out of the room. So you can... this is essentially identical to the Crystal Lockdown powers. And I guess the idea is you'd find that first before you figured out what the Crystal Men are. So it can essentially just keep people from running away through these doors. And that's nice for level 2 med bays, but it doesn't do anything else. Doesn't damage enemy crew, does not ionize enemy weapon system, does nothing. All it does is keep people from running away or keep people from getting into a room. So I don't like this as much. It's occasionally helpful, but if I could only have one of these, I'd keep the Stun Bomb and lose the Lock Bomb. That's usually my plan of action on this ship, is sell the Lock Bomb, but keep the Stun Bomb. Lock Bomb can get you a little bit more money and maybe buy something that's a little bit more effective. Now, I should mention that the combination of these two bombs, you technically don't need any new weapons to win the game. The combination of this four-man teleporter and these two weapons, these are enough to take down all the crew on Flagship Phase 1. You don't need anything else. You could kill the Flagship crew with just these three crewmen and these weapons. Now, you're going to need something else to actually take care of enemy weapons, but these are your crew-killing weapons right here. You don't need anything else. So that is very convenient. On the other hand, hard mode, the enemy offense scales quickly enough that upgrading your defenses alone is not going to be a solution to dealing with enemy offenses, especially when you get ships like this in Sector 1. Okay, that's not so bad. It could have been a lot worse. So in this case, yeah, we just want to kill the enemy crew as fast as possible. I'm not sure if... in this case, I think because we already have the three boarders, I don't think adding the NG on here is going to do me much better. So I'm going to at least try to evade the missile. I probably won't, but it's worth a shot. In this case, because they have the three-powered drone here, I know that they don't have an anti-personnel drone or anything in here. So we can just go ahead and board in immediately. Now, the Lannis is going to be a little bit weak here, but hopefully his offensive output here is going to be good enough that I can keep him kind of safe. Nothing I can do here power micromanagement-wise, so we'll just go ahead and do this. Alright, these guys should be dead fairly soon. I don't think I can prevent this from firing with a stun bomb. I think it's still too slow, so I'm just gonna not bother. Alright, pretty standard there. Took 2 damage, but definitely very possible that other ships take 2 damage there as well. And we got our Lannis healed up to free, healed up to full, which is not always possible in ships like this. Sometimes you have to do kind of micromanagement dances in order to make that happen, but he'll be nice and healthy for the next battle. Okay, unfortunately we are one scrap short of being able to afford shields level 2 here, but hopefully we'll be able to do that after the next beacon. We'll see, though. No store, so... Actually, we have to go that way. Darn. They've anticipated my path. Alright, so... Yeah, I... Actually... Huh. Yeah, how's this gonna work? So after 3 jumps, I'll be at the store. Like, if I go this way, which is my default plan, I'll be about here, and I'll be here, and I'm gonna be wasting jumps. So I think, because of my kinda poor pathing out, I kinda didn't expect there to be... Yeah, I should've seen this ahead of time. Like, I should've jumped, like, from here to here, instead of, directly to this beacon, I think. Or maybe... Yeah, I just jumped down here, instead of over here. Oh well, that's my fault. So really the question is, I think I want to double back on myself. I think the question is just, do I do it here or do I do it over here? This could be a distress, which it would be nice to get at, because now I have both an NG and a Rockman. So I think I'm going to be a little bit risky, go over here, then go over here, and then down here, and then the store. Will I have time for that? I think I'll be okay here after 5 jumps, and then I'll have time to go here, 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 and out. Alright, that's probably the best I can do. So I think I wasted 1 jump, but that's not the end of the world. Gotta keep that stuff in mind, though. Can't just go on autopilot. Sure. Alright, this shouldn't be too much of a problem. We might take damage from this burst laser 1, essentially. It's a charge laser 1, but it fires 2 shots. That's really all I'm concerned about right now. They are going to board me, though, unless I board over immediately. Which I can't, because he'll get there first, so... Alright, they're gonna board me. In this case, that's actually probably just better for me overall, because they'll board me now. I'll have 3 people in this room, and I can start punching out the weapon system reasonably soon. I don't think I actually care about him punching that system down. I'll just vent him out when the time is right. But in the meantime, all I can really do... that's alright. You're already in place. So nobody's moving there. I'll vent him out just before he damages this system bar, and I think that's about the best I can do. Okay. Alright, so that's good timing. What I wanted to do is have him leave the room before he damaged that engine's bar, but I want these lasers to arrive at my ship. Yeah, I timed that a little bit poorly, because now he's... Just now he abandoned manning the piloting. So I waited... I didn't wait long enough. I needed to get him out of there a little bit faster. So I only have 10% dodge for this particular shot instead of 15%, so that was a minor mistake there. Could have been a little bit better. That's alright, though. So now, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to just start punching down the weapon system. It's alright that these guys are taking suffocation damage from the room being empty. I just want them to be just punch this as fast as possible. So that dodge, that's a little bit lucky. He'll live in there for a little while. That's alright. And we've turned off this laser now by sabotaging it, so now we're fine. Now you can get out of there, because we don't need to dodge anymore. And we can start venting this guy out. Excellent. Oh, and we can even use these to do it super fast. You guys might as well just finish that off. I don't really care about you guys taking damage. In fact, you're probably just gonna... We're gonna clone you after the battle anyway, so you might as well just, help Adam there. Okay, that's good. I guess, yeah, you can go over there. We'll get you guys a little bit more trained up while we focus on killing this guy. Alright, you're done. You're basically dead. Yeah, you're dead. Alright, once again, pretty standard. We, pretty much only took the damage that we had to there. That's pretty standard for a lot of ships in Sector 1, is there is a certain level of damage you kind of just expect to take. Yeah, we were gonna clone you anyway. Alright, back to work. We're gonna upgrade our shields so that that sort of thing doesn't happen again. And it's probably a good idea to upgrade our engines a little bit. It gives us a little bit more protection against burst laser 2s, flak 1s, combat drones. The nice thing about the 4-man teleporter is you don't really need to upgrade your teleporter as much. Especially with the clone bay. We don't need to, I don't know, upgrade our teleporter to level 2 to board auto ships. That's just not really a concern. So really it's just make our defenses solid, at least for Sector 1. We don't really have any direct way of shutting off enemy weapons, so just having the ability to just kind of soak up a little bit of damage is okay. Eventually we'll want to buy a proper weapon, but there's not really the time for that yet. That stuff is expensive, this stuff is cheap. So just like that, in just one more battle, we've gone from having essentially one shield and two engines to having two shields and three engines, and that is a huge survivability upgrade against the nastier ships you might fight in Sector 1. So let me just double check this one more time. I think I have time to jump here, here, and then the store. You'll notice that I didn't really save up my money for the store. I don't really think that it's important to visit stores in Sector 1 and buy things in them. I think it can help, but at the same time, I don't really try to do it on purpose. I feel like having two shields and three engines and all that good stuff, I feel like that's more important for survivability than necessarily, I don't know, buying a Flak 1 or a Burst Laser 2 in Sector 1 when you still have weak defenses. I appreciate that you don't really get a whole lot of chances to do that, because the stores in Sector 2 and Sector 3 can be awful, but I think on average you're just going to be better off just rushing the defenses as fast as possible so that otherwise ordinary fights, like that guy with the two heavy lasers, that can go really badly if you only have one shield, whereas if you have two shields, he's a joke. So I feel like that's better on average. I could be wrong, but that's just how I play. I value the certain level of protection that you get from being able to get these vital early game upgrades in more than anything there. So that jump was empty, but it might not have been. It was possible that could have turned out well for me. So not going to be able to get much out of this store, but we might as well at least take a look. I could consider selling off the Mantis pheromones right now. It makes it a little bit easier for me to get the Rockman out of the way of the stun bomb if I need to do that trick. So far I don't really need to do that though. Like the only time that's gonna matter in Sector 1 is if I need to stun people in a like 2x2 weapons room. I'm not sure if there even are any on the small ships you fight in the early game. Or if like one of my crew is on really low health and stunning them makes the difference between the low health one dying or the low health one being able to just stay alive and keep contributing their damage to enemies that can't fight back. Most of the rest of the time I just use a stun bomb to stun the enemy weapons ship, like an awful ion bomb. Like if I get a free ion bomb on this ship, yeah, then we'll be able to go places. So I don't think I really feel like selling off the Mantis pheromones yet. That could potentially be useful, but I'm gonna have to keep track of when it actually is useful. As far as the lockdown bomb, Alright, so let me just make absolutely sure here. We can get 47 scrap from selling this off, so I would have 50 scrap. What would I buy with that money? Nothing? Not really any of the stuff on this side. Obviously I don't really need very much of this stuff, so really it's just a question of, do I want to buy one fuel? Yes. Okay. Done. And that was how I went shopping. So this connects to that, that's good. Do I have four jumps here? I'm not sure if I do. Well, regardless, I'm gonna be jumping here first, because that's the first one to get taken over, so here we go. Sure, yeah, we investigate those kinds of things. So this is probably gonna be our default power loadout from now. Now is when I can start considering buying one more power. Because I might want to have three engines powered and all this stuff, so fair enough. That's probably what I'll get next. Do I have three jumps? I don't think I do. I don't think I have three jumps. I think I'm gonna go here and then the exit and get out. I don't think I have time to go here and then out, so I guess that was kind of a waste then, because I spent 2 jumps to get this beacon when I could have spent 1 jump to get this beacon instead. So I wasted 1 fuel there, which was 3 scrap, so alright. Whatever, let's just move on. Games usually aren't won or lost on 3 scrap. Sometimes they are, but usually they aren't. This is usually a little bit more dangerous than normal. Anytime you have a choice as to whether to fight something, you always want to take a look at the loadout at least. Usually you'll end up fighting them anyway, but it's worth at least considering. In this case, I don't see any other weapons in this case, so I think it's just a basic laser and maybe an attack drone. And we already have our 2 shields, so this guy should not be a problem at all. It isn't even an attack drone. They can't hurt us at all. And they have a regular anti-drone, so they might have, like, an anti-personnel drone or something in here. But because they can't hurt us, and we have a clone bay, I really don't care about the lives of my crew. They could have, like, 50 anti-personnel drones in there, and I wouldn't care at all. So really it's just a question of just killing them as fast as possible, because this is just, basically a gimme. Alright, get in there. Oh, no anti-personnel drone. I guess it's a system repair bot, then. Usually, I think, like, the minimum is 2 drone levels. I don't think I've ever seen these guys with only 1, drone power. So, yeah, just kill them off. In fact, it's good that my, Lianese isn't taking much damage here. So, that's good. Yeah, system repair bot. Alright, 12 scrap and 7 scrap. Pretty standard Sector 1 rewards, but no danger at all. So my Lianese is healthy, and everybody else can hop in the medical airlock. I guess, no, you don't even have any piloting skill, and I could keep your repair skill, but I don't care about repair skill either, like, as much as I just got done min-maxing it. Excuse me. As much as I just got done, giving him some repair skill, I don't really care about keeping it, so... You know, he'll grow to be a good pilot in good time. Alright, so probably just go ahead and get a power bar. That'll keep me safer through engines, and maybe I can keep the lockdown power bar bomb powered. But I don't think I really need to yet, so... Wait, I just jumped down there after I just got done talking about how I can't jump down there. But it looks like I'm gonna get away with it, now that I take a second look at it. Alright. I guess I'm more out of it than I thought, but geez, I need to be careful. Yeah, we can aid the civilians. Alright, this is exactly what I'm talking about. It's, fights like these are... They're like the, kind of the gold standard. Not the gold standard. They're the choosing point? What words am I trying to think of right now? Like, this is what I was talking about earlier with, like, do you buy a weapon in Sector 1 stores, or do you upgrade your shields first? Right now, we have a fair chance of not taking damage from this burst laser 2, and we can still kill them very effectively, whereas if we had better weapons, we still probably wouldn't get to fire before this fired, so we would probably be taking damage from it. That's kind of what I'm going for here. Because it's just like, it's this early in the game, it's mostly about firing times and maybe evasion, as to whether you can shut something off or not, but... In this case, the limiting factor for us killing these guys is actually just getting on board before they can get on board. So we'll kill them faster than by just 3-on-2-ing them here than if I need to do this whole song and dance with the NG venting this guy out. So it's better that we just get on board, keep him from teleporting over. And that's pretty much the best we can do. We can try and dodge this bomb, try and dodge these lasers, and that's about it. Alright, so we took 1 damage, but we tried. Oh, hold on, they... wait, do we... Oh yeah, he ran off. We didn't kill him. Yeah. He was almost dead, but not quite dead. Good thing I noticed that. Alright, so we got a very nice amount of scrap there. And more scrap. Excellent. Gotta love it when the money's just rolling in. Okay, so yeah, I did actually get away with it this time, getting this extra jump in here, but I really wasn't sure, like, way back here, whether that was going to be fine in 3 jumps or not. Honestly, I'd say I got a little bit lucky, but, game's being forgiving this time. Just need to be paying more attention. If I decide something, I should actually go with my decision, instead of second-guessing myself. So we need more power, maybe, maybe not. This is around when I actually start thinking about saving up for stores, because now I have 47 scrap and this stuff to sell off, so now if I see a store right at the start of Sector 2, now I'll probably go to it. Free money. Okay. Alright, thanks, game. I'll tally up how much scrap I got later. I'm not gonna do it right now, though. Alright, Sector 2. Zoldan-controlled or Zoldan-controlled? Not a choice I want to see on a boarding ship like this one. So, usually when all things are equal, I look at choice decision points like Sector 3 or Sector 7, and try and take those into account when I pick one over here. In this case, Sector 3, I usually want a choice between two different colors. I especially don't want to go to two greens or two reds because, well, I don't want to have this choice again between two Zoldan-controlleds. And I don't want to, like, abandon sectors either. Let's see, what sectors don't I like on this ship? Zoltans. And anything that has Zoltans in it. Lania's ships aren't as much of a problem because we have the Clone Bay. In early game, that would be fine. Yeah, early game I could maybe deal with them. Although I'm gonna have a hard time turning off their Clone Bays. Right. Other than that, it doesn't really matter that much. So I think all things being equal, I'll probably pick this one. So just have a choice. And then maybe I'll go up here, maybe I'll go down there. I've got choices later, I'll figure it out. Zoltan controlled. Alright, what have we got? Well, there's a quest down there. I think, yeah, that's a Mantis War Camp. I'm not super inclined to go there. It's only a 50-50 chance at a fight, but if I'm on my way there, I'll probably do it. That's a dead end, though. Alright, so once again, we got another sector where it's a little bit awkward, but thankfully we have these jumps here to kind of retime myself so I can get to the exit last. Just gonna have to keep that in mind. And that's a dead end, so I don't want to go over there. So we're gonna look something like go up here, go up here. That doesn't connect either. Jeez. So, yeah, we're going to spend a lot of time down here, then jump, like, here and here and here and here with the correct timing. Then over here, then down there, then up there. So, yeah, I'll probably will hit this beacon. I don't think I really have any other better ones to hit. Yeah, this whole part's cut off. Well, alright. So do I want to upgrade then? Probably not. Like I said, I think, see, this is already the kind of the point where now I'm starting to consider buying stuff in stores, because now we're starting to get into expensive stuff here. 30 scrap and maybe the power to run it is not so bad here, but level 3 shields, buying level 3 shields early can be good, but I kind of feel like we need something to turn off weapons now, because we're going to get to the point where Leto missiles are not really going to be such a joke anymore. Because enemy crew are going to take longer and longer to kill off. So I need some way of actually turning them off. And a weapon is going to be necessary for that. Maybe hacking, but probably a weapon. I think we can probably get by with what we have here. I don't think level 3 versus level 4 engines is going to make a huge deal. On the other hand, how much money do I have? Because I already have, like, 100. And that's really enough to buy almost anything I want in a store anyway. So, alright. Never mind. We'll get more money before the next store anyhow. Is what I'm thinking there. Sure. Alright, make me worry for nothing. Now, a ship like this, we should be able to kill without any bombs, because they can't hurt us. That's kind of my, like, my main tentative philosophy, is that if I have all the time in the world, I should be able to, deal with a med bay or a clone bay. With proper boarding techniques, especially with a 4-man teleporter on top of that, but even with a 2-man teleporter, and just enough crew, in general, once you get good at boarding with, like, Federation C and Slug B tactics, you can deal with ships like this without having to use a stun bomb or a med bay or a lockdown bomb. So, things like this really are time-saving measures. And I don't need to save time because I have infinite time. That's kind of my philosophy on the matter. So hopefully I explained that well enough. In this case, I think I'm going to let them board and then kill them on my ship as fast as I can. Alright, I don't think, maybe I can get over there fast enough. It's gonna be close. Nah, not really. Alright. You get out. I'm gonna just go and try and clone you. In fact, we're actually gonna vent you out, because I want to kill that guy as fast as possible. I don't care if my, my own crew get cloned. I just want to kill him before he teleports back over. Alright, there. Good. That's a good technique to know in general. Like, you can beat these, teleporter timers with these kinds of self-venting techniques, and it's handy to know on Flagship Phase 3 as well, because you can sometimes kill off one wave of boarders before the next wave can come over. So, in this case, let's just take a look. So the general strategy for this kind of thing is you want to board shields. We want to get your weakest guy out of there and get the strongest guy in. Well, actually, we might be able to just do this right now because we've got three crew. So we'll get the strongest guy fighting the Mantis and the weakest guy fighting the Engie. Like so. And we kind of want to dance them in and out a little bit. We don't actually want to send them to the medbay yet. We just kind of want to go back and forth like this and kind of distract them. In the meantime, my guy in the medbay is punching it down. And he's also sucking the oxygen out of it. So he will eventually get some sabotage in. Okay, it's level 2 medbay. But you can do stuff like this and kind of get them in and out. Because they care more about the shields than they do the medbay. That's just, like, on the list of priorities, you might as well get back in there. They just care more about defending this room if my own boarders are in there than they do about, intercepting this guy. Which, to a certain extent, makes sense. If they punch down the shields, that opens them up to all manner of hazards. They just don't really recognize that it's not really appropriate in this case. They've got good oxygen levels. They, did not, suck all the air out there. Anyway, now that the medbay's broken, now we're just done. We can interfere with them pretty handily. Alright, hold on. Alright, yeah, the engine's gonna be more important, okay. I'm not sure how they decided who to fix the medbay with, it actually doesn't matter, I can send my own engine over. Or my Mantis. He's already cloned. He can do it. But in general, like, even if they fix this, it's not a huge deal. You've probably killed off some of their crew if they have extra crew. Or at the very least gotten them weak enough that you can probably pick one off before they get in there. So in the meantime, they're so weak that a full health Mantis can kill them off very quickly. And there you have it. That is how you deal with a level 2 medbay without needing either of these bombs. When you have all the time in the world. If I were in a hurry, I'd have used one of these, or maybe even both of these. Probably just one. Just using one is usually enough to win a fight, as long as it lands and you take advantage of it properly. But essentially, like, because you don't really need these necessarily to win over fights like these, where you can deal with medbays or clone bays like this with just your crew, they become more important for their secondary properties, like this one's ion damage. This one doesn't have any secondary properties, so it's less good than the stun bomb, so that's why I'm going to sell it next time we get to a store. Just didn't sell it at the last store because I thought I might need it, but I think I don't need it anymore. So we're going to go... We still got a little bit of time. Right, those don't matter, so it's really just a question of how fast I want to get here. Will it still be available after two of these jumps and two nebula jumps? I think so. So, yeah, I think we're just going to hit all of these. Then go here, and then see from there. Alright. Do we want to spend money yet? No. There could be a store up here. Okay, so we try and leave before they notice you, and we got the successful result, and this is another pathetic ship that's just like the other one. Alright. Fair enough. Where are they gonna go this time? Same place. Yeah, so you just can't intercept, like, if he teleported in here, I could have gotten here in time. But, no. We're just gonna have to do the same thing. Now, they might have a stronger teleporter this time, so I might not actually be able to kill him before this cools off. We'll see, though. Alright. Yeah, I should actually be able to let them run out of there a little bit more than I did the other time, because that's going to make them have spend more time running around than actually punching my own people out. So I should be able to do this kind of technique even with people with less health. But we're in fine shape, really. This is exactly the same as the last one. Yeah, that's basically it. Well, thankfully that didn't take too long. I will go ahead and clone you guys, though. Could use a little bit more of a topping off there. Okay, nothing's changed about the map, which is understandable. So let's see, we're gonna have 3 more jumps before we hit a store, and we're kind of sitting on 100 scrap right now, so we could maybe think about buying one more power bar. It doesn't do that much for us right now, but it would upgrade our dodge by 5%, which could matter for burst laser 2s. And our Lanius is a little bit low on health, so I guess that's okay. Yeah, like if we get absolutely no scrap at all from any of these jumps, we'll have 80-ish scrap. Well, 44 plus, it was 47, right? Yeah, 47 for over 80 scrap, which is about how much I want for a store this early in the game. So I think I can get away with doing this. So that's if I get absolutely no money at all, and I certainly think for 3 jumps I can get money at least one of them. That's my thinking. So there's the edge of that. So 2 more nebula hops and then a regular jump. I'm pretty sure I can just go here and here and still be okay timing-wise. Okay, plasma storm. This was the other thing I was thinking about when upgrading my reactor. I don't get any more power in here because I upgraded my reactor. Because it always halves rounded up. So because I was at 9 earlier, I still had 5. Upgrading that still gave me 10 divided by 2, which is still 5. I had to make it all the way up to 11 before I would have 6 power in here. Let's see what weapons they turn on. It's a burst laser that, which I will be okay with. They can't hurt me. So as long as I don't mess with their power distribution, I can just kill them any way I want to, really. So really the trick here is just going to be rearranging my people so that none of them die too soon, because I'm planning on borrowing this teleporter power to turn my clone bay back on. So as long as I go back and forth, a couple of times here, not quite. I still need to spend a little bit more time here. I don't want my Lanius dying too quickly here. Alright, that's good enough. Now I can do that, and let's get you guys out of there so you aren't 3-on-2'd. You go in there, and you go in here. And you guys should be able to clean up. Oh, that third guy actually teleported on board. How funny. Alright, I don't want to mess with, right, like I said, don't mess with their powers, so you just go up and punch down piloting while this guy takes care of the last border here. I'll turn on the oxygen once he's done cloning. And you go and help out. Actually, you just get out of there, because my, need to get a little bit more oxygen in that room. Okay, you go back and you guys take care of it. Excellent. And you're still at full health. Excellent. So, that pretty much went exactly how I wanted it to, which is always a good feeling. I'll clone these guys and I'll be right back. Right, so ion storms are actually a pretty well-designed hazard, in my own opinion, because usually you can distribute your power a little bit more efficiently than the AI can. And your main way of getting advantage is to keep shifting this stuff around as necessary, when the AI does not really do that unless systems are damaged or they start running away or something. Also got a little bit more money out of that. I think we're still on schedule. I could think about spending more money right now if I wanted to. I don't really think I need to. The only thing I'm really thinking about right now is level 2 piloting. Which is nice, but it's not really that necessary this early on. We'll see. If there's a store right here, I'll probably be happy I didn't spend it yet, but if there isn't... If there isn't a store right here, I'm only gonna find out about that when I get here. But yeah, if I jump here, and there's no store here, I'll probably do it, and by then I'll probably have a whole bunch of money anyway. So really it's just a question of do I want to just do it now anyway. Yeah, sure. It's similar logic to that power bar I got earlier. And this does make you safer. It means that if I get nicked by one laser in the pilot room, I can still charge my FTL, still maybe dodge the rest of the stuff, and there we go. I got my money back anyway. So we're still on target for my budget. This is going to be a short jump, and we should be good to go, I think. I don't need to... Now I definitely don't feel like I need to spend any more money, because I just ran out of cheap purchases. No money there, but I got money at 2 out of 3 of those hops, which is certainly justifying some of my earlier buying choices, I think. And yeah, I think... Let me just make absolutely sure. There's nothing else I want, I think. Like, I don't need more power, really, because I can turn the oxygen off, turn one of these bombs on. I don't really need the lockdown bomb much. And if I do, I can steal power from whatever's broken. So, yeah, I'll just move on. This is fine. I'm okay with these statistics at this point in the game. Okay, there's my store. Do I want to go there right now? Maybe. Or I could get more money. After I go here, I have to go here anyway. So after 3 jumps, it'll look like that. Yeah, I don't think it makes too much of a difference, but I'm gonna go ahead and... All things being equal, I'll make one more jump before the store. Maybe I'll get something for free, and I can sell it off. Okay, this is one of the most dangerous events in the game, actually. Because you get, first of all, you get boarders on board, so you get 3 mantis just dumped on your ship right away. And this ship can then also proceed to board you, so you tend to have, like, anywhere from, like, 3 to 6 mantis on your ship. In this case, obviously, this ship is pathetic, but if you get this event in later sectors, it can be a real hassle. I didn't bother upgrading doors to level 2, because we're in the early game, but usually if I run into, like, a Zoltan sector in sector, like, 3 or 4, I'll usually do this, just because this event can be kind of hard to deal with. In this case, I've got all the time in the world to do whatever I want, so in this case, I'm not concerned. Yeah, you guys just get in there. Alright, you can deal with him. Doesn't really matter. And we should be good to go. It's okay if he dies. Alright. Yeah, that's... alright. Like, I just want to make sure he doesn't break anything while my crew are cloning, but we're gonna get a new clone anyway, so we're fine. Alright, so you're all fresh, you can go in there, you finish him up. And they can't break through, because that is a single ion, and we have a single shield. And they're gonna heal that guy up, but that's okay. That's honestly fine. So we've successfully dealt with their free boarders that I got from the event, and now this just reduces to a ship that I already fought twice in this game. Remember how I'm playing on hard mode? Sometimes you just get easy opponents, alright? I mean, that's just gonna happen. With any kind of procedurally generated game, sometimes you just get a ship that's weak. But in this case, I certainly appreciate that this is like the 3rd variant of one power ship that can't hurt me. There is a possibility that they could have a Leto missile. Usually this ship has, like, 2 weapons power, maybe even 3, but, I don't know. Games are just seeing fit to only give them 1 weapons power this time around. Well, I ain't complaining too much. It's not very educational, but I'll take it. You know, can't have everything you want. I'm gonna rearrange my crew here so this weak mantis can still get to the back and keep fighting. And there we have it. Alright, So, the nice thing about taking extra jumps like this is that, now that I have 84 scrap at the store... Oh, there's a store there. Well, maybe I just skip this one? I don't know. I kinda... See, that's the trouble. If I go here, then I have to go to the store anyway, regardless of whether I'm happy with this one. So really, it's just a question of how much do I want to just guarantee that I buy something. What do I want to buy? I want to buy, like, a Burst Laser 2. Maybe a Flak... Well, Flak 1 would be good, too. I think I'll probably buy a Burst Laser 1 or a similar, like, similar two-shot laser if it shows up in the store. If there's, like, a Charge Laser 2, the 3-power laser that shoots 4, I'll probably pick that up, too. That's fine. Probably wouldn't buy a Chain Vulcan or a Glaive Beam. Would I buy a Halberd Beam? I don't think so. No. I don't think I'd buy a regular, like, Hull Beam or Pike Beam either. But any kind of laser, any kind of ion? Yeah, I'd buy an ion. That would help me take care of the Zoltan ships better. So, nearly any weapon in the game. So, really it's just a question of how likely is it that weapons show up in a store. It's kind of likely, but it's not a guarantee. And it's gonna make my life so much easier. Yeah, this is a Zoltan-controlled sector. I haven't actually fought any Zoltan ships yet. Okay. So I think with that in mind, I will go ahead and go to the back store, just to make absolutely sure I get a weapon, at the cost of another fuel and jump. Okay, what are my choices? So let's see, I'm not buying another stun bomb, thank you, game. Don't want any of these augments. This is obviously useless. This is... I'll talk a little bit about the backup DNA bank. The backup DNA bank is insurance. But it's really weak insurance because the amount of money you spend on this could usually be spent on upgrading your ship so that your people are safe. So 40 scrap is a lot of money. That's something that you grow to realize on hard mode is you need to be really frugal with your money. And if you buy stuff like this, you're putting off things like Shields 3 or Teleporter 2 or Clone Bay Level 3. Those three upgrades will keep your crew safer than this will. I mean, this is nice. This basically means your crew are absolutely immortal for the rest of the game. You will never lose them. But it's still, like, a lot of money, is what I'm saying. And this is even more money for even less of an issue, because we have an NG, we have a Rockman, we have amazing venting. This is way too expensive for what it does. So I'm happy that the balance mod makes us cheaper and more effective. Which makes it polynomially better? I don't know. Alright, so that covers pretty much everything in the store. We'll get to systems later. So really it's just a toss-up, do I want this or this? I don't like the chain laser much, but it is only 2 power. This is probably better for us later. I think this is still better, though. It is 10 more scrap, and we have to upgrade our weapon system to 3 to actually use it. And it is a little bit slow at 15 seconds, but just the power of having one more shot and the bonus fire breach and the hull damage, honestly. Hull damage probably won't actually come into play that much, but I think this is a little bit better of a weapon for us in this particular situation than this. We just want 3 shots. And if we run into a 2-shield ship that we can disable the evasion of by, like, pulling the piloting off of their chair, then this can still punch through. This can't unless we damage shields. It's usually a little bit easier to make this work, so I'm going to go ahead and buy the Hull Laser 2. So that's step one. Step two is I think we'll sell the Lockdown Bomb. We don't really need that very much. As I've shown, Stun Bomb does most of what we want as far as a bomb support weapon is concerned. Lockdown Bomb just can't deal with enemy weapons. This kind of, sort of, can. And we don't really need both, so I'll stick to my plan of this. I don't think we need the Mantis Pheromones anymore. They were nice while they lasted, but I don't think we need them anymore. We just want the money now. So I'll go ahead and sell them. And because I bought both of these, now I can buy the backup battery. And that does 2 things for us. One is it gives us 2 power. Well, it does 3 things. The first is that it gives us 2 power when we activate it. The second is that when we go to a store, the backup battery won't appear in the systems list anymore. So there will be more useful things in here. Medbay is not a useful thing. That's basically just going to clog up the system's choices. So that is out of there now. So now there will be more slots available for something like cloaking, something like hacking, something like drone control with defense 1. maybe mind control, probably not much on this ship. I don't usually buy mind control on this ship. You usually have enough stuff to win with it anyway. So yeah, that pretty much covers it. Backup batteries is out of the list. Something more important will be in here instead. So that way, later in the game, if we're looking for, I don't know, cloaking, there won't be, like, med bay, backup battery, and drone control with combat 1. That would be sad. So let's see, I think that covers nearly everything. We have over 20 fuel, so I'm not gonna bother buying any more fuel. We could probably buy some more repair. That might be a little bit prudent. On the other hand, it would put off buying weapons control. I'll buy a little bit more, just to be safe. No matter how well you play, sometimes events will just, like, damage you a bunch. You can take 5 damage from one and 5 damage from another, and then all of a sudden you're down to 9 hull, and that's really uncomfortable. So, I'll buy a little bit more repairs now while they're cheap. Up to there, one more. Okay. So I'll split the difference. You still want to have some up here just so you can get some free hull repair, but now in like one or two battles, we'll be able to upgrade this to level 3 and start using the hull laser too. Alright, I'd say we're in pretty good shape though. I might as well at least take a look here. Alright, yeah, nothing we really want, so happy we went to that first store. I would have been sad if we got this and there was no weapons in here. So, nothing we want, but you can already see that buying that backup battery is hard at work here, because now cloaking and hacking are available. Alright, so moving right on, where are we now? So we could probably jump here, maybe, then go down here, then here. What does that look like? So then it'll be about here, and then I do have time to do all these. I don't know. So I guess really the question here with my routing is, do I have time to jump directly down here, then up, then down? Because, like, maybe I care about this more than I care about this. So that would be, let's just measure out the direct route. Because if the direct route is too slow, then no route will be fast enough to do this and still get to the exit. So that'll be half a jump, well, less than half, so it'll be about this much. Well, I should do it up here. This much, then about that much for this hop. Then about that much, then about this much. I don't know, that's kind of iffy. I'm not sure that might actually make it, so it might be better off just doing these two hops. Yeah, so there's no difference between a route that does these and a route that does this, so I'll be able to better measure if I just do this, this, and this, and just give up on that, I think. Alright, fair enough. So in that case, yeah, I want to do it in this order, because I don't know if I can do this hop and then that. I think I can. I think I can get away with that, but I don't really feel like measuring it out. So here, then here, then here, then here, then here, then out. I think that's the best I can do. Okay, nothing. Okay, yeah, that's a little more than I thought, so I'm happy I did it in this order. Okay. So, cloaking, huh? And I have not gotten my hull laser 2 online to get this thing shut off yet, so we are probably just going to have to eat some damage from this, so happy I got a little bit more repairs. This kind of ship is actually really annoying, because they tend to have, we'll see when we get on. Let's just unpause. Yeah, so see, they've got that 2x2 medbay, and that's actually a real issue, because they can heal all of their crew at once. So, I think in this case, see, that's the other thing, yeah, now do I want to give up a 25% chance of dodging this missile for having a fourth border on here? We do have the backup battery. The backup battery is currently useless, but eventually won't be. But yeah, this is exactly the kind of thing I want the hull laser 2 for, to just shoot their weapons. So we're just gonna have to... I think we're just gonna have to handle this with three, I think. They probably have four people on board. I can check that real quick. No, I can't. They cloaked. I don't have time for that. Okay, so where do I want to go? Probably engines. Probably engines so I can get at least a little bit of focus in. Well, I'm gonna do doors. Because that gives me, there won't be already be a guy in there, so I'll get some free hits on people as they run in. Alright, so we got an NG, a Rockman, another Rockman. Uh-oh. Can we dodge this at least? Alright, so that's everybody who's coming in immediately. I don't need to fix that yet, so that's good. Yeah, probably a good idea to have the Mantis kill that ant. Well, not kill, but at least, Alright, I already sold my Mantis, pheromones, but maybe he can catch up. Nah. He's at 17 health. If he were lower health, if he were at, like, 8, I might try and chase after him with the Mantis and try and get some free hits on him. But I don't think that's really gonna be possible. So I really just want everybody out of there to, go to the med bay. So what next? I guess my plan is kind of like on the other ship. I want to sabotage weapons by one bar, maybe turn off the laser, then stun bomb the weapons to turn off this missile eventually. It's going to be hard. But I think... So really it's just a... Yeah, because I think they have an extra crew right now, is the thing. I don't think I can kill them all off with just one stun bomb. Let's just see who else is on board. Alright, so he's going to the med bay. You guys are going over there. You're going into weapons. Wait, so you went around the long way. So they only have three crew? I guess they only have three crew. Alright. Okay, so the stun bomb is ready. As soon as we can punch down one of these weapons, I can at least turn off the Artemis missile. I could still think about maybe boarding with the NG, but I don't think I really need to right now. I just want to have try and dodge this next missile. After that, I'll think about it. Alright, where is this going? Alright, still hit. That NG is going to be out of the med bay eventually. Right now, in fact. And we actually turned the missile off. Okay. Well, in that case, I will go ahead and board with the NG, then. The missile's off. So we don't actually need the stun bomb anymore. I mean, I'm gonna keep it on anyway, but... So now the idea is to just keep boarding them over and over again and never, ever let them fix the weapons. Which we can do. Our crew is stronger than their crew are. So yeah, their Rockmen are going to be busy healing the medbay. I think it's a weak medbay for now. And in the meantime, we're sabotaging their weapons, we're sabotaging their shields, we're sabotaging their cloak. It's going to be a little while before they can get out. So, we're doing good work. So no more cloak for you. No more shields soon. No more weapons soon. And we're going to overwhelm them eventually. Yeah, so they're way too busy doing all that other stuff. In fact, well... Nah, we can't really sabotage the medbay yet, but we'll get there. So you can see that they're already, like, some of them are heading back to the, you go and do some useful... Nah, he couldn't get out of there fast enough. Alright, that's fine. I just want to give them as much work to do as possible, so that they never get around to actually fixing the weapons. Fortunately, we have a level 2 clone base, so we're going to have two more borders pretty soon. Alright, I see him sneaking over there to try to fix the weapons, but we're not going to let him do that. At least I hope we aren't. Alright. Surprise. Alright, so step 2 is going to be to break their oxygen. We don't need the stun bomb yet, still, because my plan is to break the oxygen, and then they're going to be so busy that all the oxygen will be out of their ship, and then we can overwhelm them in the medbay. See, we've already got two more borders, so we're going to hop over here. They're going to be too busy trying to fix these shields, and they're going to get that done. Alright, you've pretty much done everything you need to for the time being. But yeah, now this is how you start making advantages. I don't really care what you guys do too much. I guess you can go back and shields, yeah, that's fine. Does not really matter that much. I just want to start sucking the air out of these rooms. These important rooms. Alright, now everybody into here. We want to keep the Lanius alive as long as possible. So it's okay that our people are going to die here, because, yes, now we're out of air. He works especially fast now the oxygen system is busted. Yeah, in fact, I can tell that this is a level 1 medbay, because you can see that as I advance time, they're not healing in there. Yeah, he's just going to be stuck there forever, because he's going to be waiting to heal. Because the medbay only just barely keeps you alive in there. I could use a stun bomb now if I want to speed this up. I mean, I have 30 missiles for crying out loud. But, I don't really need to do that, so I'm just kind of demonstrating that. Okay, they got, that fixed in the meantime. But, that's alright. Oh yeah, that's actually another fun thing where I actually broke their AI a little bit. He's actually so weak on health that he sees the medbay as a threat, so he got out of there. So, even though they're very weak on health, they don't want to go to the medbay because there's no air in there, because their AI tells them to run away from rooms that don't have any oxygen in there. So, they won't run away. So now, we'll go ahead and break that, just for good measure, I guess. There should still be an engine in there, because, yeah, like I thought. Still at exactly the same health as we left them. He was just waiting in there until he was at full health. So now I'll run out, because he wants to find a room that has actual air in it. And there. So that's how you kill a ship without needing any stun bombs. So really, like, the consideration was, do we fire a stun bomb to take care of the weapons? But we actually just wound up taking care of the weapons without even using the stun bomb at all. So, these are the kinds of strategies you need to use on Federation C, on Slug B, on Mantis B, on boarding ships that don't really have a good support weapon. We're gonna have a support weapon soon, which is this whole laser 2. In fact, I'm gonna get that online right this second. But, that's the kind of stuff you need in order to, get the job done. Alright, so looks like my timing is good. We'll be able to jump here, then here, then here, then out. Yes. Alright, unmanned ship. We actually didn't... This is actually the first one we've seen. We will go ahead and board with three people. The only threat to us is that missile right now. So actually, no, I'm not even going to wait for the Lanius to get his, get himself over there. We're just going to go ahead and board immediately. Because the nice thing about boarding ships with clone bases, you can just board immediately, and two people working together to punch down a weapon system can do one hull damage before a missile like this can fire. So that's about 7 seconds. That's my rule of thumb measurement. So the nice thing about that is we actually punched it down before it could even fire. And there's other similar situations where you can do one hull damage before their main weapons fire, and that can turn their volley from harmful to harmless as well. Now in the meantime, well, we actually have a hull smasher laser once. We can just, now we can just shoot it down. Right, if we didn't have this laser weapon, we'd just keep punching out their systems, make sure that we always had two people on hand to deal with the rocket launcher. Yeah, like that. And see, that's how precise the timing is. I actually waited, like, I hesitated a tiny little amount on that, and it did fire, so... Unfortunately, we do have to actually dodge this. I was hoping that we would actually dodge that, but we don't. But, oh well. Sure, we always participated in research facility studies. 9 scrap and lovely stiff dough. Alright, we've got enough power with our backup battery, but it would be nice to have a buffer bar for this whole laser too, so we could use both the whole laser 2 and the stun bomb, and if we take 1 damage in here, we can still use the whole laser 2. So, it's kind of a toss-up between, do we save up for, like, drone control and defense drone 1, or do we just spend 35 scrap on the defense for that? I don't know. Probably save up for the drone control, honestly. Because we can, as long as we're, like, not taking damage from, like, our shields are still pretty good, stop taking damage from missiles, then we can just, start saving up for shields 3. That's a pretty good upgrade path, and none of that really involves upgrading the weapon system. Like, if we can just get our defenses solid, maybe we don't have to care about this for longer. On the other hand, this is something we can do immediately. But we don't have to make that choice yet, because we can't make either of the choices. Okay, a pulsar. This is another thing that's always scary for boarding ships, because it's something that's going to remove your defenses that you can't really do much about. So I'm happy that we have a conventional weapon for this, and I'm also happy that their offense is apparently terrible. You know, considering this is a rebel disruptor, having one basic laser and no attack drones in a pulsar is pretty benign. So let's see what they hack. They don't even have any medical facilities, so... I'm gonna wait to see if they hack my teleporter, but if they don't, I'm just gonna board them. What are they hacking? My engines. Okay, get over there. Alright, so as long as I can just shoot them in their, shoot them here, in their weapon, then we should be fine. It's possible that their, repair bot might, fix that while I'm not looking. So to solve that problem, I'll just beat it up. I said, to solve that problem, I'll just beat it up. Alright, pretty smooth for a pulsar, I'd say. Now I'd like to... Oh yeah, that's the other thing about pulsars. If your crew die, then they're in danger of the clone bay being ionized. I didn't let that happen. But that's still something to worry about. So in this case, I can't actually clone them yet. We're just gonna have to go to the next jump with them hurt. And deal with the consequences. Thankfully, we're jumping to the exit, so usually that won't be a fight. Sometimes it is, but usually it won't be. Hire a crewman. No. We have 5 crew. That's already 2 more than I'm used to working with. So we're in excellent shape. Honestly, this 4th Engie, he's a 4th boarder. So now I can have a team of 4 people on board the enemy ship, and I can still have a pilot, which is excellent. Okay, that's Sector 2. Next sector is a choice between Zoltan Homeworlds or Rebel Controlled. So we have the tools to deal with Zoltan shields now. Rebel Controlled is generally just kind of an average sector. Sometimes there's, like, auto ships in it. You're gonna fight, like, auto ships and asteroids and auto ships and suns if you go to Rebel Control. Honestly, that is what you're gonna run into a lot of the time. You'll fight, obviously, Rebel fighters and Rebel riggers and pirates and stuff, but you're gonna fight Rebel ships of all kinds in there. And that's pretty standard difficulty. You can deal with them with pretty standard tools. Zoltan's is mostly pirates, but sometimes it's Zoltan ships, and very rarely it's NG ships, and then, of course, there's Rebel ships as well, of course, but... Not as many. Not too many Rebel fighters in there. I think it's mostly Rebel riggers and auto assaults, so things with drones. Obviously, there's the Zoltan quest in here, but so really it's just a question of how much do I care about fighting Zoltan ships. A little bit. I have the whole laser 2 to help take care of their shields a little bit. It's going to take about 3 volleys, I'm going to say. Because let's be honest, some of these are going to start missing now. We're in Sector 3. I can get the stun bomb online. That might help a little bit. So that gives me more stores, which is a slightly better chance at a defensive drone as well. Or that, because that's really what I'm aiming for here, is just that's the most practical way of getting rid of missiles. Cloaking helps too a little bit, but other than that, we can kill enemy crew decently fast. Mind control and hacking are just not quite as good missile defenses. Although hacking combines offense and defense, because you can block people out, but it's not as good in Zoltan homeworlds, obviously. I don't know. This will be more exciting, I think. Like, let's say that I had no choice but to go to a Zoltan sector, just like I had in Sector 2, honestly. We didn't fight very many Zoltan ships, so yeah, let's try fighting some Zoltan ships and get more exciting. I'd say we're in pretty good shape for the end of Sector 2. So I think we can handle it. Let's try it. Zoltan Homeworlds.